Polo G could potentially be quitting music due to this reason. If you guys are a Polo G fan, make sure you guys watch this video all the way until the end because he may never be creating any new music again. Also, if you are a Polo G fan, make sure you guys leave a like on this video right now and don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you would like to join our iPhone X giveaway. Now, Polo G has been a viral sensation ever since the release of his hit songs Pop Out featuring Lil TJ and a single that he created called Battle Cry. Now, all the way back in 2016, Polo G started his music career with uploading heavy drill type songs while he was in and out of the legal system. Now, Polo G did state in an interview that he was arrested once 6 times back to back, and something serious was said to him the last time that he was in court, which we will be talking about here in a second. So, I highly suggest you guys keep on watching this video until the end, because not only is he maybe quitting due to the legal system, but he has been going through a lot of serious mental problems as well, so make sure you stick around to hear about it. Now, Polo G did state in that interview that he did with DJ Vlad that these court cases that he was in, these cases were no, you know, serious cases that could have like left him locked up for the rest of his life or anything. He didn't take anybody's life or anything along the lines of that, but what was serious about these cases was the fact that during these times, he actually could have taken the lives of others. He didn't actually ever do it, but he could have. And that is what made the cases so serious. Now, he stated in the interview that he did with DJ Vlad that his first arrest was actually during a high-speed chase on the highway where he was driving in a stolen car with his friend that he found in a parking lot. He got caught while in this high-speed chase after crashing the car when making a turn in an intersection, and this is where it actually caused a lot of the problems for Polo G. Now, yes, obviously being in a high-speed chase itself is something that is illegal and you will most likely get locked up for it, but what made the case a lot worse for him was the fact that this all happened on New Year's Eve. And if you know anything about New Year's Eve, then you would most likely know that everybody is usually outside. They're, you know, walking around the streets, they're going to bars, pretty much just hanging out in the streets in general, all celebrating together for the new year. And because of the amount of people that were outside when this all happened, it actually put the lives of many in danger. And this actually could have resulted into something that could have kept Polo G locked up for the rest of his life. I mean, you know, if he was just literally a couple minutes earlier when he, you know, crashed the car during the turn at the intersection, there could have been people where he crashed the car. I mean, he got really lucky that there was nobody there at the time it happened. Now, the court told Polo G that he got very lucky that nobody got hurt during this incident, and I mean, I'm pretty sure that he knows that deep down inside too. And also, the court went on to tell him that if he gets locked up one more time within the next 5 years for anything, he will be facing a few years behind bars due to the amount of priors that he had within the last 3 years. Now, as I said earlier, if you remember, Polo G has got locked up 6 times back to back to back. I mean, the high-speed chase was most likely the most, you know, severe one out of all of them. All the rest ones were just, you know, little amounts of narcotics that he was caught with or that he was trying to move and sell. So, you know, those aren't, you know, crazy amount of, you know, severe court cases, but the high-speed chase is really where they got Polo G because of the, you know, how fast he could have taken the lives of many people. And especially because it was on New Year's Eve where there's tons of people out on the streets. I mean, this could have ended very bad for him, and I think I know that Polo G most likely is very happy that nobody got hurt during it, and that he most likely did learn his lesson. In that interview that he did with DJ Vlad, he did say he got locked up 5 to 6 times all back to back, and as I said, it was mostly for possession, but this high speed chase again, luckily nobody was hurt during the chase, because then he would be facing most likely life locked up if anything really drastic were to have happened. Now, enough of Polo G's legal issues, let's jump into the next part of Polo G's current problems, which is going to be his mental problems that he's going through right now and what he's facing. Now, I'm pretty sure every single rapper goes through a phase where, you know, they're really down on their luck, you know, they're not having the best mental, you know, thoughts and all of that. I mean, just literally a couple weeks ago, Lil Pump went through the same thing where he just wanted to be left alone. He didn't want to talk to anybody. He felt like he was failing. All of this stuff was going on with Lil Pump. But I'm pretty sure every single rapper goes through this phase, and I think it's now starting to hit Polo G. Now, a lot of his tweets actually were deleted. I don't know if it was from him or if it was from his management team, but this one was left up. I will have it up on the screen. It says, "Ain't no tears coming down my eyes, so I gotta make the song cry." Basically, he's gonna be releasing a bunch of, you know, sad type of music. He wants to have the lyrics, you know, lyrically hit you, kind of, if that makes sense, where, you know, it's all truthful stuff that he's saying in his music. And I mean, this isn't really a terrible idea for Polo G. I mean, a few songs on his last album were actually kind of like this, and I kind of really enjoyed it. But still, I think that this is probably just a new beginning for Polo G. I mean, a lot of people were scared that with all of the stuff that he was tweeting, that he was actually going to be quitting music due to all of these, you know, mental issues and problems that he was going through. He just needed some time to just regain, and he just needed some time to regroup himself so then he can come back out in the music scene. Now, a lot of people were mentioning that, you know, they were scared that he might be quitting music. I just wanted to add this part into the video because, honestly, a lot of these rappers will go through this phase. Literally, some go through this phase, like, once every 2 months. It's nothing to be scared about if you were a Polo G fan and maybe you were scared that this might be happening. It won't be happening at all. If anything, Polo G, I think, is signed to a legal contract that he has to do with his record label. He has to put out a certain amount of albums and songs, so it's not like he can really quit anyway. But anyways, guys, I am going to be ending the video here. If you guys did enjoy, please leave a like on it and subscribe to the channel if you guys are new. It has been District Trending, and I'm out. Peace.